Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Padide Ganda Chonitina Nime
Chapter begins with Lord Krishna protecting the child Parikshit who is within the womb of Uttara. Uttara means the wife of Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu had been killed in the battle of Kurukshetra, but his wife was pregnant at the time, so she continued to live, and within her womb was the child, Parikshit.
Uttara 呢是这个 Abhimanyu 的妻子，那 Abhimanyu 呢去战场作战，后来他战亡了，所以这个老婆 Uttara 呢还怀着肚子还怀着孩子，
那这样的情况。So Ashwatthama, the son of Drona, he had wanted to kill that child.
那Ashwatthama 的这个 Drona 家人的儿子，他想要把那个巴利杰他们杀掉。
And with this purpose in mind, he threw the Brahmastra weapon.
那这个一个特别有一个武器呢，是这个 Brahmastra, like mantra, is it?
Yeah,
Brahmastra.
It true weapon by mantra.
对，就是说用念出这个咒 曼陀罗的这样的武器。
And Lord Uttara saw the Brahmastra saw the weapon coming towards her, and she ran to Lord Krishna and prayed to Krishna to protect her child.
那乌特尔看到这个情况呢，就跑到 Krishna 那儿边去，祈求 Krishna 来保护他这个孩子巴利杰。
And at that time, Lord Krishna appeared in the womb of Uttara and protected the child from the heat of the weapon.
那个时候呢 ，Krishna 就进入到 Uttara 的胎中，然后保护他胎里面的孩子。
So this happened just before Lord Krishna was leaving for Dwarka.
这个情况发生在 Krishna 就要去到 Dwarka 之前。
This was after the battle of Kurukshetra. Lord Krishna had seen how the Pandavas had come victorious in the battle of Kurukshetra, and Maharaj Yudhisthira was placed on the throne.
这个情况呢发生在库鲁兹野战争结束之后，那么 Krishna 呢看到的潘度这五兄弟他们对方获胜了，然后呢就要把 Yudhisthira 立即殿上王位。
So the first 17 verses of the chapter describe how Lord Krishna protected Maharaj Parikshit.
所以前面的十七个十节呢，就描述的那个巴利杰国王呢，怎么样被 Krishna 所保护拯救着。And
then verses 18 up to 43 are the prayers by Queen Kunti.
然后十八到四十三节呢，是昆蒂皇后所献上的祈祷。So
there's 26 prayers there.
就是有二十六个祈祷。And
we'll be looking at some of the important prayers.
我们来看其中的一些重要的祈祷。And
after Queen Kunti offers the prayers, then the final part of the chapter is text 44 up to 52, and we hear how Maharaj Yudhisthira approaches Lord Krishna filled with lamentation.
然后呢，在昆蒂皇后祈祷之后呢，接着就是说。 这个情况，那个尤地西普拉国王呢，去到 Krishna 那边呢，他是满怀着悲伤。He
was lamenting because so many millions of people had given up their lives in the battle of Kurukshetra.
他在那边难过感伤，是因为在 库鲁兹野的战场上呢，数百万人丧命。So
Maharaj Yudhisthira considered it to be. Because of his own desire to have a kingdom, that all of these people had met with death.
Yudhisthira 国王呢，他感到难过，是自责，由于他自己的想要登基成为国王的愿望而造成那么多人的伤亡。
Maharaj Yudhisthira was feeling very guilty for this purpose, and he approached Krishna.
尤迪斯特国王呢，他感到觉得自责罪过，所以他去到 Krishna 面前。So
that's the main parts of this eighth chapter.
这个是在这个第一篇第八章的主要内容。The
eighth chapter, this first section, will hear Krishna's preparing to leave for Dwarka. The battle of Kurukshetra is ended, and Maharaj Yudhisthira is placed on the throne. And now Krishna is preparing to go back to Dwarka to see his family.
所以这个就是在这个库鲁兹野的战事结束之后呢，那尤地士国王呢，他已经登上王位了，所以 Krishna 这时候准备就是这边事情完了，准备去到 Dwarka.
And then at that time, Ashwatthama released this Brahmastra weapon by reciting mantras. He released a deadly weapon which was meant to kill the child in the womb of Uttara.
那这时候这个 Brahmastra Ashwatthama 这个武器呢
Uttara being the wife of Abhimanyu, and Abhimanyu is the son of Arjuna and Rukmini. Abhimanyu is the son of Arjuna and Subhadra.
So this Abhimanyu is Arjuna and Subhadra's son.
So with the weapon coming towards Uttara, she runs towards Krishna for protection. And Krishna reciprocates. Krishna covers the embryo from within the womb of Uttara and saves both the child and the wife of
Uttara.
Here you can see. So there's a verse which was recited by Uttara when she came running towards Lord Krishna. Pahi Pahi Mahayogin Deva Deva Jagatpate Nanyam Twad Abhayam Pashi. This is the verse which she's calling out to Krishna. She's saying, please protect me, O greatest of mystics.
This is Uttara, she's praying
and she understands the supreme position of Krishna. She's describing him as Deva Deva. He's not just a Deva, but he's Deva Deva. He's worshipped by the Devas.
So,
and he is Jagatpati, the Lord of the Universe. And she says to Lord Krishna that there's no one else who can save me from the clutches of death. So you can see in the illustration, the child Parikshit is in the womb, he's in there.
我们可以看到这个里面的图像，就是说。 那个巴利杰国王当时还在这个胎中里面。
Lord Krishna has appeared as the Paramatma, the Super Soul, and he's protecting the child from the heat of the Brahmastra.
那奎萨就以超灵的形体出现，然后在这个胎中呢，来保护这个孩子，巴利杰。So
Lord Krishna is Paramatma, he's everywhere. He's situated in every atom. So he's already in the womb of Uttara. He didn't need to enter into the womb of Atma. He was already there. Lord Krishna is not only omniscient, he's omnipresent.
Krishna 不只是无所不知全知的, 而且是, 遍布遍存万有, 处处都在的。
And this was shown here how he protected the child.
这边就是说展示出了他怎么样保护这个孩子。
So here you can see here from the 10th verse how Uttara is praying to Lord Krishna.
第四,1810这个诗呢告诉我。
She said, oh my Lord, you are all powerful. A fiery iron arrow is coming towards me fast. My Lord, let it burn me personally if you so desire. But please do not let it burn and abort my embryo. please do me this favor, my Lord.
所以 Uttara 就这样祈祷说，哦，我的主啊，你是最有力量的，一个就是说炽热的铁的火，这个剑呢，往我这边快速的穿飞过来了。我的主啊，就让他直接来烧着我，如果你愿意的话。但是请他，不要让他去烧到我的这个胚胎哈，不要让我流失这个胎儿，请你为我做这一项啊，帮忙我。我的主啊。
So you see the loving nature of the mother, that the mother said, let it burn me if you want, I don't mind, let it kill me, but don't let anything happen to my child.
啊，这边也同时可以看到一个母亲那个对孩子的爱，在极端危险的时候是宁愿自己受伤或死亡，而不愿意孩子受到伤害。
Okay. So,then we go on, after of course Krishna protected the child, and then Queen Kunti along with all the Pandavas, they appear, and they want to offer their prayers to Lord Krishna.
然后我们就知道了 Krishna 是确实保护了大家，然后就接着呢，就是说跟着是 Kunti 皇后她的祈祷是这样子。
You can see in the illustration, Lord Krishna is seated on the chariot,and he's preparing to go to Dwarka, and Kunti has come forward along with her five sons, the Pandavas, and they're praying to Krishna that they want him to stay longer.
我们看到这个图片上的 Krishna 坐在这个车上，那边昆蒂皇后带着她的五个儿子，就是这个阿朱纳、潘达巴这五个兄弟哈。然后他们就跟 Krishna 请求 Krishna 再留久一点，不要这么快就走。
Lord Krishna had come and spent so many days there helping the Pandavas through the difficulties in the battle of Kurukshetra.
那Krishna 在那待了很多天了，就是留在这个库鲁兹野这边帮忙这个潘度的这个五个儿子的这个这边的战事。
And they want to remember Lord Krishna how they helped so much.
那他们就是 Krishna 帮了他们这么大的忙，所以他们想要一直记得 Krishna.
So Kunti, the chaste devotee, and her five sons and Draupadi, they all came to address Lord Krishna.
所以这样子呢，主呢就从让他们从这 Brahmastra 这个 mantra 这个武器中保护他们免于这些辐射的伤害。那昆蒂是主 Krishna 一个贞洁的奉献者。
And here is the first verse, the first prayer, which is offered by Queen Kunti.
这边是昆蒂皇后的第一个的祈祷文。
Right, you can repeat after me.
大家跟着老二念，大家跟着念。
Kunti Uvacha,
Kunti Uvacha,
Namashe Purusham Twadyam,
Namashe Purusham Twadyam,
Ishvaram Prakrite Param,
Ishvaram Prakrite Param,
Alaksham Sarvabhutanam,
Alaksham Sarvabhutanam,
Antar Bahiravashtitam,
Antar Bahiravashtitam.
Srimati Kunti said, O Krishna, I offer my obeisances unto you because you are the original personality and are unaffected by the qualities of the material world. You are existing both within and without everything, yet you are invisible to all.
Kunti 皇后就这样说Krishna, 我向您顶拜致敬，因为你是最原始的人格，而且你不受物质自然的品质所影响。你既在里面， 也在外面，在所有生物所有一切的事物里，但是你却无法让所有的生物都看到你。
So Lord Krishna is the son of Vasudeva and Devaki.
Krishna is this Devaki and Vasudeva's son.
And Vasudeva is the brother of Kunti.
Vasudeva is Kunti's brother.
Kunti and Vasudeva, brother and sister, they were the children of Maharaj Surasena.
Kunti 皇后跟这个 Vasudeva 呢，他们这个兄妹呢是这个
Surasena
的孩子，他们两个都是 Surasena 的孩子。
So while Kunti was a young girl, her father gave her away to his friend Kunti Bhoja, who had no child.
在 Kunti 很小的时候呢。他的父亲呢，把他就说过继给Bhoja。
Kunti Bhoja。
Kunti Bhoja， 因为 Kunti Bhoja 没有孩子，所以等于说给他养。
Kunti Bhoja was a friend of Maharaj Surasena, so he felt this he has no child, and because Surasena had several children, he said, "You take this girl, she'll make a nice."
因为昆蒂那边的他是波加那个的他们长辈是好朋友，但是呢另外一方呢没有孩子，所以这边有孩子比较多呢，就把这个昆蒂给他们养。
Initially she was known as Prita.
Prita.
But then when she became connected with Kunti Bhoja, she got the name Kunti.
她原来的名字叫 Prita， 但后来她被过继给那个那边的时候，就改名字改成 Kunti。
So Kunti is like the aunt of Lord Krishna.
所以 Kunti 就像Krishna 的姑妈一样。
But here you see Queen Kunti is saying, "I offer my obeisances unto you."
虽然是这样的身份，但是在这里我们看到他对 Krishna 说：“我向你来顶拜。”
Now usually culture is that the nephew or the niece will offer the obeisances to the aunt.
在文化上文明是这样子，像这个侄子啊、外甥啊这一些，应该向这个姑姑、婆婆、叔叔、阿姨、长辈来致敬顶拜。
But Queen Kunti is explaining why she offers her obeisances to Krishna.
Kunti 皇后就解释着为什么她来向 Krishna 顶拜。
She said, "You are the original personality."
就是说 ，Krishna 呢是最原始的人格神。
Right, you are Purusha. You are the original person.
你是 Purusha， 你是最原始的人。
Not just a person, but the original person.
不只是人，而是原始最起源的人。
You are Ishvara, the controller of the material nature.
而且你是 Ishvara， 就是控制者啊，控制物质自然的控制者。
So you're not affected by the material, the qualities of the material world.
那你并不会被物质世界的品质所影响。
This is Lord Krishna's supreme position.
这是 Krishna 他的至尊地位。
And then you are existing within and without everything.
而同时呢，你就是 Krishna， 你处在所有一切之内跟之外。
But at the same time, you are invisible.
虽然是这样，但同时呢，对大家来讲，你是无法被看见的。
So this is also described in the Bhagavad Gita in Lord Krishna's own words.
这在《国家梵歌》里面也有描述的啊 ，Krishna 自己的话语里面有描述。
When Lord Krishna is speaking to Arjuna at Kurukshetra, at that time Lord Krishna said, Matāparātaramnanyat kinchit asti dhananjaya. Mai sarvam idam proktam sutre mani gana eva. Lord Krishna is saying to Arjuna, there is no truth superior to me.
就是国家梵歌里面呢，嗯，克夏对阿朱那说，没有任何其他真理高过于我。
Everything rests on me, just like pearls are strung on a thread.
所有一切都包含在我里面，那就像这个所有的珍珠呢，被绳线所串住的。So
just like the pearls are beads are on a thread, you don't see the thread, you only see the beads.
嗯，就像这个。 珠子啦，珍珠啦，它串在一起的时候，只看到这个珠子，而没看到里面的线。So
in the same way, everything is resting on Krishna.
嗯，所以是这样的同样道理，所有一切都是处于 Krishna.
But he's invisible to
everyone.但同时呢，Krishna呢却无法，人们无法看到他。And
he's within everything, and he's also outside of everything.
然后Krishna呢，他在所有一切之内，也在之外。So
Queen Kunti is wondering. Actually, she's trying to understand Lord Krishna's position.
嗯，所以昆蒂皇后就试着在了解 Krishna 的地位。
Is he localized or is he all pervading?
嗯，就是说 Krishna 到底只是处在某一个位置呢，还是他是全部的弥漫的存在着？
Of course, he's both. He's both localized and all-pervading. He's all-pervading as an all-pervading super soul within the heart of every living entity and within every atom.
他是遍存万有，他存在所有之内之外，也住在每个生物的心里面。
And at the same time, he's a person, and he's standing in front of Queen Kunti.
同时他是一个人，然后他就直接站在昆蒂皇后的面前。So
Srila Prabhupada's purport elaborates more on this, and Prabhupada writes, Srimati Kunti was quite aware that Krishna is the original personality of Godhead. Although he was playing the part of her nephew. Such an enlightened lady could not commit a mistake by offering obeisances unto her nephew. Therefore, she addressed him as the original Purusha beyond the material cosmos.
昆蒂皇后是非常的知觉的，Krishna是原始的人格首身。 虽然Krishna扮演的角色是昆蒂皇后的一个侄子生外甥这些的地位，但是呢，像昆蒂皇后这么一个已经领悟的灵魂，肯定不会因为跟 Krishna 就是跟他的这个下晚辈来顶拜而有任何错。因此呢，昆蒂皇后就称呼 Krishna 是原始的 Purusha 原始的人格首身，他是超越所有物质宇宙的。
So Srila Prabhupada describes Kunti as being an enlightened lady.
包括就描述的昆蒂皇后呢，是一个启蒙的，已经有觉悟启蒙的女士。Certainly
she was a very, very elevated soul because she was the mother of the five Pandavas who were all greatly devoted to Lord Krishna.
肯定的，她是一个非常非常进步、高超进步的灵魂，而且呢，就是她拥有这个像这个五兄弟这个儿子就是潘度这个五个孩子，阿朱那他们。And
she was the aunt of Lord Krishna, but she also knows that Lord Krishna is the supreme personality of God.
那在角色上呢，她是 Krishna 的一个姑母这样子。 但是他同时也知道 Krishna 是人格的人格首身。So
Queen Kunti is almost on the level of Krishna's mother Yashoda.
所以呢，昆蒂皇后就差不多是 Krishna 的母亲亚修达这样子的地位。
Very, very elevated soul.
是一个非常非常进步高超的灵魂。
And she's teaching us how to offer prayers to Lord Krishna.
她在教导着我们怎么样来向 Krishna 献上祈祷。
So she describes him as the original Purusha beyond the material cosmos.
那她就描述 Krishna 是原始的 Purusha， 就是。同时也超越所有物质的一切。
We're in the material cosmos. We're caught up in the material nature. But Lord Krishna is beyond it.
我们身处于物质宇宙里面，我们被物质宇宙所困住了。但是 Krishna 一点也没有被困。
But he's come into this world for purpose of performing his pastimes.
Krishna 来到这个世界是来进行他的逍遥时光
，killing the different demons and at the same time giving pleasure to his devotees。
出来呢杀害那么多的恶魔，同时来保护他的奉献者。
Lord Krishna had, from his very childhood, he had dealt with demons like Putana, who came trying to poison Krishna as a baby。
那 Krishna。杀了很多恶魔啦，比方说布坦纳啦，他想要来杀掉 Krishna， 以他自己的奶来去毒害他。
And Lord Krishna had picked up the Govardhan Hill as a young child, and in this way he protected all the inhabitants of Vrindavan.
然后 Krishna 就只是一个孩子哈，但是呢，他可以自己去Govardhan山，然后来保护 Vrindavan 的居民们。
And he had come to Kurukshetra and taken the part of the charioteer for Arjuna and helped Arjuna to overcome all the obstacles.
然后他来到库鲁之野，然后呢，作为Arjuna的战车的车夫，然后为他驾车。
So Queen Kunti was offering her first prayer in that way.
所以昆蒂皇后是以这样的方式来献上她的第一个祈祷。
And the second prayer that's shown there on the board.
第二个他的第二个祈祷文是在这上面。
You can repeat after me.
马拉子念的，我们跟着念。
Maya jivani kachanam,
Maya jivani kachanam,
Abhyadhok sajam avyayam, Nalakshyase mudadresha,
Nalakshyase mudadresha,
Nato natya daroyata,
Nato natya daroyata.
The translation, being beyond the range of limited sense perception, you are the eternal, irreproachable factor.Covered by the curtain of deluding energy. You are invisible to the foolish observer, exactly as an actor dressed as a player is not recognized.
所以昆蒂皇后第二个祈祷就这样说的。你是超越的物质感知的有限的范围，你永恒的是你被这个就是说那个物质幻象的能量的这个帘幕把你遮盖着，所以让人们是永远无法直接跟你交流。你是对愚蠢的观察者，是无法见到你的。就如说一个演员呢，穿上了他表演的戏服在舞台上，而人们无法认出他原来的样子。
So Lord Krishna is described by the word adhoksaja, meaning he's beyond the senses.
所以 Krishna 也被描述为是 adhoksaja， 也就是说他是超越感官的感知。
Right.Many of you here are working in the science field. So you're working with your senses. Of course, with different instruments, you use different instrumentations, but it's all knowledge or measurements acquired by the senses.
那在座有很多位都是在做科学跟技术方面的研究，那我们都是在应用你们感官在做事情，是借用这个各种仪器来进行的，但是呢，也需要这个感官来运作。
But Lord Krishna is beyond the power of the senses.
而 Krishna 是超越的，就是说感官的能力。
There are many things we are not able to understand with our limited senses.
这个世界上有很多的事情，我们无法以我们有限的感官来了解。
Alright, we have our eyes are very limited. What we can see with the eyes.
我们眼睛也是很受限制的，我们能看到的也很有限。
The cats can see in the dark. We're not so able to see in the dark.
猫呢可以在黑暗中看得很清楚，可是我们在黑暗里面却无法去看到。
And the sense of hearing in many animals is greater than the sense of hearing in the human form.
然后这个听力呢，聆听在很多的动物呢，它们的听力是远远的超过人类的听力。
So there's so many limitations with our senses.
所以我们的感官是有很多的，就是局限、有限度的。
And often the knowledge we get from our senses is imperfect.
而就是说，最终因为有限的感官，我们得到的这种。 讯息或知识就是不完美的。
Certainly it's limited and it's often also imperfect.
所以肯定是有限的，而且是不完美的。
And Lord Krishna is beyond the sense. We cannot understand Krishna simply by the senses.
那 Krishna 是超越我们这些所有一切的有限维度。
So Queen Kunti understood this qualification of Lord Krishna.
所以昆蒂皇后她了解Krishna的这个资格。
And she describes how Lord Krishna is covered by a curtain of deluding energy.
而她描述说Krishna呢被这个 就是迷幻的能量的这样的布帘帷幕所遮盖着。
Just like we have a curtain here, behind the curtain, then the deities are there.
就像我们这边呢，也有这个帘子哈，那这个帘子后面就是神像哈，神坛的神像在那边。
So we're not able to see the deities because they're covered by the curtain.
由于这个帘子这样子盖起来遮住，所以我们无法去看到神像。
In a similar way, Lord Krishna is covered by the curtain of Maya, the illusory energy.
同样的情况呢，Krishna呢就是以这个 迷幻物质的迷幻能量 ，Maya 的这个布帘所掩饰住。
And then Queen Kunti gives an analogy to help us to understand this.
那昆蒂皇后给我们做了一个比喻，让我们来了解。
She said, just like an actor dressed as a player is not recognized.
就像一个演员呢。 他去装扮之后呢，就是一个表演者，那人们无法辨认到他原来的情况。
Sometimes you may see your friend taking part in the drama.
也是如果你看到你的朋友在参加这个话剧表演。
But you're not able to recognize him.
他化妆装扮之后，你可能没办法认出他来。
Maybe they have a different dress on. They're covered. Their appearance is so different.
他们就可能就是他们的衣着啦、化妆啦、装饰啦，就是跟原来的样子不一样。
In the same way, Lord Krishna comes into this world, and he's appearing like an ordinary person.
同样的呢 ，Krishna 来到这个世界，然后他出现为一普通一般人的样子。
And certainly looks human-like.
当然他外表看起来就是人的样子。
But we have to understand that he is not, while he appears to be human-like, he is not of this material world. His body is spiritual.
但是我们必须要了解，就是 Krishna 虽然出现人的，跟我们一样的人的形体，但是他的身体是灵性的，是超越这一切物质的。
So this was described by Krishna again in Bhagavad Gita. He said, Abhijananti mammutha manushintanam ashritam. The foolish mock at me descending amongst them like a human being. They do not know my transcendental nature and my supreme dominion over all the beings.
那么啊，克夏自己在《薄伽梵歌》里面有说啊，就是说这，克夏出现的
Transcendental nature and supreme dominion over all the beings.
克夏是超然的本质这样的显现了，超越所有一切的现象。
So there's the example again given by Queen Kunti. Just as an actor dressed as a player is not recognized, so you are invisible to the foolish observer.
所以啊，昆蒂皇后又在重复用这个例子来说，就是说 Krishna 对于愚蠢的人是看不到他的。就像一个演员呢，经过装扮成为一个表演者呢，就没有办法被认出来。
So the dramatic artist is dressed for the part, and his own family members cannot recognize him.
所以就是在一个戏剧里面呢，这个表演者、艺术家呢，他们换装，装饰之后呢，连他的家人都没办法认出他来。
Srila Prabhupada describes, he says, a child, he is seeing somebody acting, but the child has forgotten that this is his father acting. Because the father has dressed in a different way, and he's a different posture, playing on the stage,Although the child is sitting amongst the audience, he cannot understand that, oh, he's my father playing.
偷他呢，这样说的，用这个例子就说，有一个小孩，他看着舞台上有人在表演，但这个孩子忘记的是他的父亲在上面表演，因为这个父亲已经以装扮成另外一种样子，而且是另外一种姿态，在舞台上。虽然这孩子坐在这个观众之间呢，但是他并没有办法明白那是他的父亲在做表演。
So like that, if somebody is a good actor, you know, then the people in the audience, they won't be able to recognize who is who.
所以是这样子，一个好的演员呢，他在台上的各种情境、姿态、表演呢，人们没有办法，不会看到他原来的那个样子。
In the same way, Lord Krishna comes into this world.
同样的，Krishna 以这样的情况、这样的方式来到这个世界。
And 5,000 years ago, Lord Krishna came, and there were people.Who met him? They didn't know Krishna was God.
那五千年前的时候，可想来到这个世界，但人们呢并不知道他是神。
Not everyone is able to recognize, oh, this is the supreme personality of Godhead.
并 并非每一个人都领悟到，就说这就是至尊人格守神。
There were different, many different people who didn't recognize Krishna at all.
事实上是非常多的人一点也都没有辨识出 Krishna。
Dhritarashtra's sons, headed by Duryodhana, they did not recognize Krishna.
像 Dhritarashtra 的儿子 Duryodhana， 他也没有去认出 Krishna 的身份。
When Lord Krishna first came from Vrindavan to Mathura, there were several people they did not recognize Krishna.
当 Krishna 首先去到 Mathura 的时候呢，在 Mathura 那边也有很多人也没有去认出 Krishna 来。
Lord Krishna met Kamsa's laundryman, and Kamsa's laundryman was carrying a lot of nice cloth which belonged to King Kamsa. And Lord Krishna had just come from Vrindavan.
那么Krishna 去到路上呢，遇到这个康萨的这个洗衣房里面的人，然后他带抱着一大篓子的很好的衣物，但是 Krishna 刚从Vrindavan过来。
So Lord Krishna thought it would be nice to have some of the nice cloth which the laundryman had.
所以 Krishna 看到就想说，如果说能有这个洗衣人的这么好的衣服啊，可以有的话也很好。
But Kamsa's laundryman became angry and said, "Oh, you cheeky! This cloth all belongs to King Kamsa. You have you punished if you take any of this cloth."
那么这个康萨，这个他的洗衣工人就是说，你呀，这个你这么狡诈的人呐，这么调皮呀，你如果把这个衣服拿走啊，这个衣服是这个国王康萨的衣服啊，你如果拿的话，你会被惩罚的。
So not everybody could recognize Lord Krishna.
就是没有每个人认出 Krishna 来。
People sometimes say, "Why doesn't God come today?" But even if He came, could you recognize Him?
人们也在说，为什么神不出现呢？但是如果神真的出现在你眼前，你认得出他来吗？
All right. So, So Prabhupada continues narrating, he was talking about the child in the audience and he could not recognize the father, but the mother sitting next to the child, and the mother, she can say, "Oh, don't you see your father is playing there?" So although the child and the mother is there, one cannot see and the other can see. That means one who has got knowledge, he can see. One who hasn't got knowledge, he cannot see, although God is everywhere.
所以这个就这样的解释，这个母亲就会说呢，难道你看不出来是你的父亲在那边表演吗？虽然这个孩子还有母亲两人都在那儿，但是一个可以认出来，另外一个没办法。这个表示说，一个人有的知识的话，他可以看出来；但是一个没有知识的人，他就无法看出来。虽然神是处处都在。
So, this is a position that some people have knowledge that they can see God everywhere in everything.
所以是这样子，有知识的人呢，他可以在各个时候各个地方都见到神。
This was seen in the case of Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj, the great child devotee who was tortured by his father, demonic father Hiranyakashipu.
这方面的例子就是 Prahlad Maharaj 的例子，他呢受到他父亲各种方式的虐待，要把他杀掉。
Prahlad Maharaj was asked by his father, "Where is this God?"
Prahlad 受着他的父亲的质问， 神在哪里？你说的神在哪里啊？
In fact, atheistic, materialistic people often will ask us, "Where is this God? Why can't we see Him if there's a God?"
啊，在物质上的这些无神论者就常会说，哦，哪里有神？我们又看不到他怎么有呢？这些说法。
But Prahlad Maharaj said to his father, "He's everywhere, Father."
嗯，但 Prahlad, Maharaj 对他的父亲说，他是处处都在的。
And then Haranikashipu then said, "So is he in here? Is he in this pillar?" And Prahlad said, "Yes, Father, he's there also."
所以 Haranikashipu 就说他在这个柱子里面吗？但是 Prahlad 说是的，他也在这柱子里面，他是处处都在的。
And then Haranikashipu smashed the pillar.And from out of the pillar, Lord Nrisimhadeva appeared.
那么啊，嗯，这个杨雅开西部啊，不愿意去接受，不相信，就拿着他的剑去往这个柱子这样挥过去，那这个柱子就蹦开，这个主女性的灯就从那里出现。
So those who have got devotion, they can see God.
嗯，所以一个具有奉爱的人，他能够见到神。
And those who have no devotion, they cannot understand.
而没有奉爱的人，他们却无法了解。
Lord Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, "I am never manifest to the foolish and the unintelligent. For them, I am covered by my eternal creative potency."
那么可是在佛家梵文里面就是说，我永远不会被那愚蠢不智不明智的人所了解所见到，我是永远的被这个迷惑的能量来遮盖着。
So what does it mean to be foolish and unintelligent? It means to if you cannot understand that there's a God behind this material world, behind this creation, then that is foolish and unintelligent.
那说到愚蠢，还有不聪明、不明智的人是怎么样的人呢？就是说，在这个世界，他们不明白有一个至尊主，他是超越所有的物质这种世界。如果不能了解、不能这样接受的话，他就是愚蠢、不聪明。
So.Srila Prabhupada writes in his purport, "For less intelligent men, there must be such things as temples, or mosques, or churches, so that they may begin to recognize the authority of the Lord and hear about Him from authorities in such holy places."
Prabhupada says, "For less必须要这些存在，有庙宇啦，寺院呐、道观呐、教堂啊，这样子他们才可以来开始去辨认出主的权威，而且去聆听从权威那里去聆听关于主的一切，而且是在这一些神圣的地方，庙宇啊、教堂之类。
So temples or churches or mosques, either way.They're meant to give proper spiritual education to people.
所以呢，庙宇啦，教堂啦，道观寺院啦，他们的用意是要给人们来做这样的教育。
People need to hear about the nature of the Supreme Lord, that there's a God behind the creation.
人们必须要来聆听关于这样的真理，就是说。是有至尊主的存在，而且他是超越这物质的创造。
And that one supreme Lord is the ultimate authority behind everything.
而这至尊主是最终最高的权威，是超越一切的。
So it's a failure of the modern society that even though people may go to temples and such places.They just simply go to perform some ritualistic ceremonies.
那如果人们只是到庙里啦、到教堂啊去做一点 祭祀仪式呢，这就是这个教堂跟庙宇的失败，因为人们只是因为仪式性而去做。
We go and we ring the bell, then we break the coconut.
去到庙里可能摇摇铃铛啊，然后或者做一点所谓把这个椰子打破啊什么。
But the real purpose in going to the holy place, to the place of religion, is to hear about God.
去到这一些宗教的地方的用意呢，就是要来聆听，听着关于神的这样的知识。
And we have to understand that he is a person, and he is the supreme person behind this whole cosmic manifestation.
同时，我们也必须要了解他，就是主，他是至尊主、至尊人，他是超越所有宇宙的存在。
And he has a form, and he has qualities, and he has activities.
而且他有形体，他有品格，他有活动。
So we can hear about him, about the different wonderful attributes and activities which he performs.
所以我们可以来聆听关于他的各种各种展示，各种活动。
And hearing, the more we hear, then the more we can understand the nature of that personality.
我们越加的聆听，我们就越加的了解主的这个人格性。
And we can understand our own limited position in relation to him.
然后呢，我们也可以来了解跟他的关系里面呢，我们是有限的生物。
That we are very limited and lacking in so many ways.But he is unlimited. He is the infinite.
但是我们是有限的生物，而且呢，我们在很多方面都缺乏不足。
We are the infinitesimal. We're very tiny in comparison to him.
所以我们跟他相比较，我们是无限的渺小，无限的微小。
So it's very purifying for us to hear.About the Lord and about His activities.
所以呢，我们来聆听关于主还有主的活动呢，是对我们来说非常净化的。
We're always hearing. We're hearing from many people. You go to lectures and you go to college and you go to so many educational institutes and you hear from different people and you accept their authority.
那我们喜欢聆听，我们去很多地方听啊，去很多的寺庙啦、教堂啊，或是去各种学院啊，或是讲堂啊、大学啊，我们喜欢要去听聆听权威人士的讲述。
So we need to hear from the devotees, from the people who read the scriptures. We need to hear from authorized sources like scriptures.Which can tell us about the position of the Supreme Lord.
所以我们必须去从奉献者那边聆听因为他们了解，然后让我们了解到呢主的至尊的地位，还有至尊的品质。
So that is the beginning of education.
这是教育的开始。
When we start to understand.That we are not the human body, but we are all spiritual beings eternally related to the one Supreme Lord.
就是这样子，我们了解我们是灵性的灵魂，而不是这个物质躯体，而且我们是永恒的。
So Queen Kunti has said like that, that.She's very humble. She's a very humble lady, and she's saying like that, "Katam pashyemahi striha." She's saying, "How then can we women know you perfectly?"
Kunti 皇后是一个非常谦卑的女士，非常的谦卑，所以她又接着说，那如何的？接着，我们如何像我们女子呢？如何能够知道你，可以完美的知道你呢？
Queen Kunti has said, women, they're not very much interested. As soon as they become devotees, they also promote it, but generally they're not interested.
是这样子，女士们、女子们，她们一般呢对于这些哲学真理没有兴趣。一旦她们变成奉献者的时候，她们就会被提升，而且一般呢，一般来说，女子们呢对这些没有兴趣。
Women very much interested in family life.
女子们呢对家庭生活很有兴趣。
Very much interested in the body.
对身体很有兴趣。
We see most of the shops for the women.
我看到大部分的商店的商品都是给女士们。
It's ladies' clothes and ladies' dresses and ladies' shoes. Yeah, there's a much bigger market for women than there is for men.
衣服啦，鞋子啦，胜过于男子的。
And so generally women, you know, they have a lot of attachment to the material world. Naturally, the ladies won't agree, you know. Generally not interested. But, no, they are interested as soon as they become devotees. They become devotees. So, and we see ladies also become devotees, very nice devotees. The ladies do so much service. Woman come down, she can translate that. So ladies, in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna has explained that society is divided into four divisions. And so, Chaturvarnam Maya Shishtam Guna Karma Vibhagasha. Right? Chaturvarnam, the four varnas, there's the Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Sudra, four divisions of society. So Brahmana, first top, the educated, the learned, and they're also inclined to spiritual practice, the Brahmana. They will want to do spiritual activities. The Kshatriya, they're the manager. And the Vaishya, the businessman, and the Sudra, the worker. So four divisions of society. And in that Vedic society, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, they are considered upper class. The Sudra is considered the lower level. And then Lord Krishna explains that even though you be of lower birth, and then he mentions who is of lower birth, and he said, Striyo Vaishya Tata Sudras Tepi Yanti Parangatim. Lord Krishna said, Mami Partha Vaya Pashritya Yepi Shru Papa Yunaya Striyo Vaishya Tata Sudras Tepi Yanti Parangatim. Even though you be of lower birth, like women, Sudra, and Vaishya. So not only ladies, you know, Sudra, Vaishya, they're all lower birth, but they can all achieve the supreme destination. And in the Kali Yuga, it is said, Kalo Sudra Sambhava. In the Kali Yuga, everyone is born by birth, Sudra or lower. So we may be thinking, no, I'm Brahman. Really? maybe I'm Bhattacharya or I'm Sharma or whatever, you know. We're thinking I'm Brahman. At Kali Yuga, there's no Brahmins, right? Everybody is born Sudra or lower. But we can be elevated by samskaras.
But Maharaj, it's the Brahman, Vaishya, Shudra. So where are women in that, in those four?
We are not. We are Vaishya.
No, women.
Women.
Where are they?
You're not in that. Women are not in that.
Not
only
in
men.
Oh, okay. So
women
are
all
different
categories. Stree. Stree, Vaishya, Stata, Sudras.
Oh.
Stree. Women. Stree Dharma. Women are meant to do Stree Dharma. Means meant to be married. Right? Mm-hmm. Meant
take
to be a,
mm-hmm.
Take care of your family. That's the Stree Dharma. Kali Yuga, women going to work. Women engineers. So many. Women soldiers. Women bus drivers and everything. So we're talking about the position of women.
讲到这个一般女子的这个地位，她的情况。And
Prabhupada saying generally women are not much interested.
嗯，啊，爸爸说的一般而言呢，女子们呢。 对这些知识哲理不没有兴趣。
But once they become devotees, then they change.
嗯，一旦他们成为奉献的，他们就改变了。
Prabhupada says, not that even though they become interested, they keep behind. No, but equal force with men, they also promoted. So following her footsteps, any woman can also understand Krishna. So I was explaining from the Bhagavad Gita how Krishna said there are four divisions of society.
我就在解释着，就是说，Krishna在《普迦梵歌》里面去说明了这个社会呢怎么样的分种四个阶层。
And Krishna said, low birth means the Vaishya and the Sudra.
那Krishna说到那个所谓出生低等的，就是说 Vaishya 还有 Sudra.
And women.
还有女子们。
But they can all achieve the supreme destination.
虽然是这样，但是都是可以到达至尊的这个目的地。
Prabhupada explained, women in general are unable to speculate like philosophers, but they are blessed by the Lord because they believe at once in the superiority and almightiness of the Lord. And thus they offer obeisances without reservation.
爸爸继续说呢，一般而言呢，女子们是没有办法像哲学家那样来推敲思辨，但是他们受到主的祝福，因为他们相信权威，而且相信主的全能，因此他们。
They're more submissive than men generally.
所以一般女子一般来说是比男子更加的臣服。
And they can accept the supreme position of the Lord.
而他们可以来接受主的至尊地位。
And they don't mind to come to temple and to bow down before the Lord.
然后呢，来顶拜，向主来顶拜。
But they might find it difficult to be philosophical.
那或许他们会觉得在哲学方面是比较困难的。
Some women, some rare women, philosophers.
当然很少数的女子是哲学家。
But generally, common women, ordinary ladies, they're not usually very philosophical.
但是一般的普通女子呢， 是不太有哲学思维的。
But they can be very devotional.
但是他们可以是非常的怀有奉爱。
And that devotion is more valuable than being philosophical.
那这样子呢，这个奉爱呢，是比这个哲学更有价值。
Prabhupada writes here that the Lord is so kind. He does not show special favor only to one who is a great philosopher. He knows the sincerity of purpose. For this reason only, women generally assemble in great number in any sort of religious function.
主是这么仁慈，他不为所谓大哲学家显，是偏爱。他知道这个所谓真诚诚恳的目的，由于这个单单就是这个理由，女子一般都会在任何的宗教场合里面的聚集群聚。Queen
Kunti was saying that Lord Krishna can only be known by those who are pure at heart and who are great philosophers.
昆蒂皇后说呢，啊，科夏只能被那些心地纯洁的人呐，伟大的哲学家所认识。And
Kunti was saying, how can we women know you?
昆蒂皇后就说，那我们这些女子们呢，妇女们呢，怎么能够认识你呢？
Generally, in the past, you know, the scriptures were heard by men.
在过去呢，经典上的灵性述说是由男士们在进行。
They were addressing men.
所以就是称呼那个男子男士。
But of course now today of course we have also so many ladies also.
当然呢，现在我们已经有很多是女士们在进行的。
The women are no longer at home.
就是说现在的妇女就不再像以前只待在家里。Right,
they've all gone out from the home.
很多都不在家里。So,
times have changed. Okay, so. Anyway, this is Queen Kunti's humility.
这是昆蒂皇后的谦卑。
She's expressing the difficulty which she feels that I'm just a woman, how can I ever know you?
昆蒂皇后表达说，我只是一个女子而已，一个妇女，我怎么能够知道你呢？
But that humility is appreciated by Lord Krishna.
但是他那种谦卑是Krishna所欣赏的。
Lord Krishna is in the heart of everyone, and he knows the purpose, the sincerity of everyone's heart.
Krishna 在每个生物的心中，他也很清楚地知道每一个生物的情况。
So Lord Krishna is not so much impressed by what we give to Krishna, but what we don't give.
Sorry.
It's not so much what we give to Krishna, but it's what we're not giving.
Krishna就是，对于我们说给他，他没有兴趣，那他在意我们。
So someone may be a great philosopher. So someone may be a great philosopher. But they're just depending on their own mind and senses. They're not actually really surrendering to the Lord. They're simply listening to their own mind. philosophers, usually speculators, right? And 我们说思辨家的人，他们没办法了解 Krishna. And so just by philosophy, by speculation, the power of our own mind, then we'll be limited to the material. But we've already said Krishna is adhoksaja. He's beyond the mind and the senses. Do Krishna chalgo woman the singi, chalgo woman the gangwan, woman who pay young woman the gangwan, or to woman the singi, leojia Krishna. How can we then understand Krishna? Woman sevenang leojia Krishna, woman shiyo tobi Krishna. We have to surrender to Krishna. And Prabhupada says, women, they come in big numbers and said they're very humble. And they surrender to Krishna. They will offer their obeisances, they will bow down, they will do all kinds of menial service. So that service is appreciated more than any great philosopher. I'm saying women do a lot of menial service for Lord Krishna. And Lord Krishna sees how they bow down without any reservation. So they're also, they're very advanced devotees. Somebody may be a great philosopher. And we may be quoting so many scriptures and so many verses. But that doesn't impress Krishna. What impresses Lord Krishna is the sincere desire of the devotee.
然后呢，你会让 Krishna 留下印象，就是这个奉献者他的真诚。
So Queen Kunti is describing this in her the beginning of her prayers, and there are many prayers, but in the first section here, she's describing the her humble. She's taking a very humble position.
所以呢，在这里呢，昆蒂皇后献上很多个祈祷文，然后在这里呢，表现出她一个非常谦卑，她自己放在一个很谦卑的地位。And
that humility is a very important quality.
谦卑是非常重要的品质。Chaitanya
Mahaprabhu also spoke about humility in his Shikshastikam prayers.
啊，就提到嘛，普布也在他的。
关于谦卑这件事也在他的八训规里面提到了。Very good. Yes. Yes, one should chant the holy name of the Lord in a humble state of mind.
人呢，应该是以非常谦卑的心态来念诵主的圣名。
One should think oneself lower than the straw in the street. Our ego should be in proportion to our spiritual dimension.
Right.
What is your spiritual dimension?
你的灵性的和维度，灵性的。
Do you know your spiritual dimension? What is the size of the spirit soul?
灵魂的大小是怎么样？头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，头发，
Yeah.
So our ego should be in proportion to our spiritual dimension.
所以我们我这个身份应该跟我们自己原来灵魂的维度啊一样和谐的。
And in this way, we should offer all respects to others. This is humility. Come to the spiritual platform. Alright, any questions? Anybody has any question?
Earlier you mentioned Krishna will not appear in front of stupid or foolish people. But being stupid is not someone's fault.
What?
Foolish is what?
Being stupid is not someone's fault.
Maybe he didn't get. He was not privileged enough to get the knowledge, or he had bad company.
Krishna不会把自己揭示给那个愚蠢的不聪明的人。那他提到说，一个人不聪明不是他的错。
Well, it's not by chance that someone's in that condition.
如果一个人他愚蠢啊，也不是突然间偶然变得愚蠢。
You know, everyone has their own karma.
每个人都有他的 karma 业报。
So somebody is blessed with the opportunity to get a lot of education.
有些人得到祝福而可以得到很高的教育机会。
And some people don't have that. Some people, even though they get the opportunity, they don't take it.
而有一些人，即便他有这样可以去受好的教育的机会，但他不去接受。
Just like when you were in school, when you were a schoolboy, some people they never study for any of the exams. They don't care, you know, about the exams. And other people, they're trying very hard, they want to get really good marks. And so everyone has their own particular nature and ambition.
就像我们在学校里呢，总是会有一些人他不去上课，不去听课，不交作业，不去考试，但是有一些人呢会很认真的上课啊，听课啊，写作业，参加考试啊。 就是说每个人他都有自己的所谓自己的个本性。
So why is somebody foolish and unintelligent? It's their doing. They've done it, they've arranged it themselves by their neglect of education.
那为什么有一些人他是愚蠢不聪明啊，就是因为他们自己造成的，因为他们没有努力去接受教育。 然后就会自然造成愚蠢。
Just like, you know, you may get, you're doing postgraduate work or something, you know, you're working, you have to put a lot of effort there to pass so many exams and to enter into these different fields. It didn't all happen by chance.
就像说，你们到在研究所里面学习啊，研究啦。 那这个也不是你突然就可以进去研究所，也是你们之前经过很多的努力学习，经过考试，然后经过各种一关一关的，然后才能进到研究所，不是说偶然你就可以进去。So
everyone suffering and enjoying according to their past activities.
每一个人他的痛苦快乐都是由于他过去活动的结果。
Somebody is foolish and unintelligent. They put themselves into that situation.
有一些人就是他愚蠢啊，不聪明，不明智啊，是他们自己把自己弄到那样的境地。
that they didn't care to take up any studies and to try to improve their situation. They could come, you know, they can come to temple and hear, go to temple, and in the temple people are reciting scriptures, they could go and hear. They're not required to pay a lot of money for these things.
就是说这样的人呢，他们就可以来庙里啊，这样来聆听哈，去到庙里这样聆听真理讲学。那么到庙里不说要付很多学费。
But they don't care to do it.
即便是这样，他们也不在乎，不愿意去做了。
Rather, they think ignorance is bliss.
反而他们认为愚昧、愚蠢是一种祝福。Some
people have that idea about life.
有些人对生活有这样的概念。So
Lord Krishna talks about people who are foolish and unintelligent.
所以Krishna对于这个愚蠢的啦、无知的，还有这不聪明的人来讲述。
Why? Because they're not seeing that behind this world there's an intelligent person.
为什么呢？因为这些无知的人呢，他们没有见到，在这个世界之外呢，有一个最聪明至高的人。
When you look at the material nature, you can see so many elements of design.
如果我们去看物质自然呢，是有很多种元素。
Even when you look at the body, every living entity's body, there's so much design there. Look at our own human body, the eye, how it's designed in such a special way that it can perceive different things.
刚刚看我们自己个体的这个身体，如果以眼睛来讲。 这个即便是物质元素，但是它也要经过很多的结构，元素的很精密的、恰当的结构，可以让你的眼睛可以很好的去有这个视觉。So
we have a division within our own Krishna consciousness movement, the Bhaktivedanta Institute, and they're concerned in presenting scientific knowledge to the Nobel Prize winners and to the prominent scientists in the world to convince them that life does not come from matter.
我们在国际科学知觉协会有一个分部，就是巴蒂维丹达研究机构，那里面呢，也对于这些诺贝尔得奖者啊，诺贝尔学者，还有科学界的这一些学者们呢。 可以让他们知道这个真理，生命不是来自物质，生命来自生命。Life
comes from life.
生命是来自生命。So
we have to understand there's person, there's supreme intelligent being behind this creation.
所以我们必须要了解是有人存在，他是至尊人。 它是超越所有物质的智力，所有物质的一切。This
is understood by Queen Kunti.
上面这里说到的这个叙述是，昆蒂皇后她已经了解的了。So
she's presenting this to Lord Krishna.
所以她把这个呈现给 Krishna.
How she begins her prayers.
这个第十八节是昆蒂皇后她这样子的开始来做她的祈祷文。Now
we are concerned when we do see people in unfortunate conditions. Somebody is, as we said, foolish and unintelligent. They don't have to remain that way.
我们呢，所以去遇到那个不幸的人，他们无知哈。 无知的受困，但是他们不必要去一直留处在那种无知的状态。Karma
is not eternal.
业报 karma 不是永远，不是永恒。Right,
you may be enjoying some good karma, but it can finish very quickly.
或许你在享受好的业报，但也有可能很快就完结束了。
In the same way, bad karma can also end in karma kinship.
同样的道理，坏的恶报也可能就很快就结束。
Unfortunate souls and foolish, unintelligent people, they can be changed with proper education, proper association.
不幸的人呢，愚昧无知的人呢，可以通过恰当正当的教育来被提升。
So it begins by hearing.
这个提升的开始从聆听开始。
But we have to hear from the proper channel through the proper line of authority.
但是我们必须要从这个恰当的管道啊，恰当的权威、正当的权威那边来聆听。
Just like you study material science, you want to hear through.Proper authorities through authorized, qualified people. So similarly, in spiritual knowledge, you want to hear through a proper channel.
啊，就像你们呢，来求学呢，要学这个科技科学项目，那你们也是一定会去找这个正确的来源啊，正确的权威来给你教导，让你去学习。
Okay. Any other question?
其他问题吗？
Okay, then we'll finish here.
那我们就在这边的讲述，今天先在这里结束。
Hare Krishna.
Recording stopped.